Having so many options for tools when it comes to moving around your alcohol ink can be a bit overwhelming, but I'm here to help. I'm going to quickly go through the tools that I've used in the past, and then I will share my new favorite tool, and you cannot find it in the craft store. I do want to say that every tool moves around the alcohol ink differently and can be used for various techniques, but I like having one tool that I can use most often. So we are going to start off by addressing the heat tool, the embossing tool. Although this tool is convenient because most of us have one already in our craft room, it gets too hot and can melt the Yupo paper, and it also dries the alcohol ink way too fast. The next tool is a regular hair dryer. Now you can buy hair dryers with cool and low settings. It's just honestly way too big to handle when I'm doing alcohol ink techniques. Not to mention, where am I going to put it? And even on the low setting, I find the airflow to be a bit too much. Tim Holtz came out with a great tool, and I even reviewed it about a year ago here on my channel. It's small and it doesn't produce any heat, and you have a lot of control when it comes to moving around the alcohol inks. Sounds pretty perfect, right? Well, it was the perfect tool for me until about 6 months ago when I started suffering from joint pain in my hands, and I was recently diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis. I can only get a few squeezes before my hand starts cramping up. Now, I'm only saying this because I have gotten asked several times if this particular tool is good for people with arthritic pain. And although I do love Tim Holtz products, this particular tool is not for me. But I do keep it on hand because it is good for certain techniques, but I won't be using it for a full alcohol inked background. We went over a few of the other tools. Now comes my new favorite find. I immediately fell in love with this tool. It's small, the airflow is just about right, it doesn't get too hot, and it's not that expensive. This is the Conair Hot Air Curling Hair Dryer, and I want you to see if you could say that five times fast. That was a mouthful, and it took me a few times to get right. Anyways, it comes with two attachments that you obviously do not need, and the blower is perfect for the technique that I do most often. I am going to quickly share a few tips that I hope you find helpful when using alcohol inks. I like to use Yupo or craft plastic paper. I find that the alcohol inks move the best on this type of paper. I always have a small bottle with a fine tip filled with 91% isopropyl alcohol. The fine tip gives you a little bit more control when adding the isopropyl alcohol. I start by adding a few drops of alcohol ink to the paper because I want a more smoky look to my alcohol ink. I'm going to be adding a lot of isopropyl alcohol to my paper. This is going to dilute the color and help blend it out better. When I use the blower, I use it on low airflow as well as low heat. I also do not put the tool directly over the ink. I keep it a little bit off to the side, fairly close to the paper, but having the air blow from the side will help move that ink around, and it also doesn't dry up the alcohol ink as fast. You can see how I am slightly tilting the tool so the air goes towards the ink, but I'm still keeping it off to the side, and I'm not putting the tool directly over the ink I want to move. Instead, I'm allowing the air to move the ink from the side. After using this tool for a few months, I have found that I have gotten the most consistent results with this tool. Now that I have shared my thoughts on the perfect tool, let's talk about a cheaper option for paper, simple alcohol ink techniques anybody can do, and so much more in this short playlist right here.